Okay, this question number 19 from set on equation of waves is a doubt of one of the students. So I thought of discussing this. So here it's asked, at what minimum time will the line joining P and Q become horizontal? Line joining P and Q becoming horizontal means that P and Q are having same displacement. So they have same y coordinate, then only the line joining them will become horizontal. Frequency of the wave is given, and it's given that in the first case, so I will be solving only the first case here. So in this first case, the wave is traveling in plus x. So if the wave is traveling in plus x, then you can see that this point Q, it's moving in upward direction and P is moving in downward direction. And P is right now at a by 2 and going down. Q is located at root 3 a by 2 and going up. So let's draw the circular phase diagram to represent these two particles which are undergoing SHM with their respective circular motion particles. So P is at plus a by 2 and going down. Okay, so at plus a by 2 and going down means the particle P which is undergoing SHM will be represented by this P dash, which is the circular motion particle. Particle P is over here. As far as Q is considered, Q is at root 3 a by 2, so above this P. So this is where the Q is, but this Q dash will be here because Q is going up, so the circular motion particle should be in the first quadrant. Okay, now see this, because this P and Q are undergoing SHM with same omega, because in traveling wave all particles undergo SHM with same omega, which means that their corresponding circular motion particle have same angular velocity. So the angle covered by P dash and angle covered by Q dash will always be same. Okay, now what you do is you join this P dash with origin and you join this Q dash with origin. Now we already know that this angle is 30 degree and this angle is 60 degree. Okay, now what is P dash doing? Circular motion. What is Q dash doing? Circular motion. And with same angular velocity, P dash going like this, Q dash going like this. And so what we can say is that this P dash going anticlockwise, Q dash going anticlockwise, so this angle between them will be maintained as 90 degree. So P dash going anticlockwise, Q dash going anticlockwise, so this entire two lines, this P dash show and Q dash show will be rotating in anticlockwise, and angle between them is maintained here as 90 degree here. Okay, so it is like you can say that you have a L-shaped rod kind of situation, and you have to rotate this L-shaped rod. So for example here, if this P dash O becomes like this, then Q dash O becomes like this, then P dash O like this, then Q dash O like this, then P dash O here, then Q dash O here. So this L-shaped rod will continue. Okay, now we have to check at what time will P dash and Q dash have the same y coordinate. Okay, so let us rub all this. See, P dash and Q dash will have same y coordinate means so it should become like this, same y coordinate. See, the thing is P has already crossed positive extreme plus a by 2, and this P is already going down, and right now this Q is going up. So by the time Q has already gone up and coming down, P is already moving down. So P will cross this mean position, which means this P dash has crossed this position point, position, let's call this position as a position R, and this P dash is still moving anticlockwise. So basically what is happening is this line is rotating, as I already said. I think this rotating line funda, with that we will be able to explain or understand better. So initially this line was like this, and now what we have to do is we have to keep rotating. So how do we rotate this? So we have to keep rotating this line like this. It's not rotating. Somehow the software is not helping me to rotate this entire thing. Yeah, so this thing keeps rotating like this, anticlockwise. Only when the two lines are, let's call those two lines as P dash O and Q dash O. Only when these two lines are equally inclined to X axis, then only the line joining P dash and Q dash, or should I say line joining P and Q, will become same, because only when either on the top side, like P dash O here and Q dash O here, only when they are equally inclined, theta theta, then only we can say that P and Q have got the same y coordinate. And whether this happens above the origin or whether that happens below the origin doesn't matter. P dash here, Q dash here, so their corresponding SHM particles P and Q have the same y coordinate, and so the line joining P and Q in that string will become horizontal. So when will this happen, that the line joining P dash and Q dash will become equally inclined? Because this entire thing is rotating in this way, so this angle theta is decreasing. So a time will come when P dash is here and Q dash is here, then after some time what will happen, P dash will be here and Q dash will be here. See, again they should make equal angle with the x axis, and on the same side also, not one above and one below. Otherwise one will have positive y coordinate, other will have negative y coordinate. We don't want it. And so this P dash will keep going like this, and this Q dash will keep going like this, and after some time what will happen is P dash will come here, Q dash has come here. So P dash and Q dash, and then P dash goes like this and Q dash comes like this. And then when P dash is in fourth quadrant and Q dash is in third quadrant, then at some time it will happen that these two lines are equally inclined to X axis, and both P dash and Q dash are below the X axis. So after some time, because P dash has gone from here to here and Q dash has come from here to here, and so these two lines are equally inclined to the x axis, let's call it theta theta. So this is 90 minus theta, this is 90 minus theta, but the angle between P dash and Q dash is always maintained as 90 degree. So 90 plus theta plus 90 plus theta is 90 degree, so theta is 45, and so this angle is also 45 degree. So this is the time when the line joining P dash and Q dash will actually become horizontal in the actual string. And what is the location of P dash? P dash is here in the fourth quadrant at an angle of 45 degree. But what was the initial location of P dash? Initial location of P dash was here at an angle of 30 degree, I guess. Yeah, 30 degree. So from 30 degree above in the second quadrant to 45 degree in the fourth quadrant, how much angle this P dash needs to cover is 30 degree plus 90 degree plus 45 degree. So that will be like how much, 120 plus 45, so 165 degree. So if 360 degree requires a time period 2 pi by और टाइम पीरियड इज़ 1 बाई फ्रीक्वेंसी. आई थिंक लीनियर फ्रीक्वेंसी इज गिवन इन दिस क्वेश्चन. क्या 125/6. सो वट इज़ द टाइम पीरियड? 6/125 सेकेंड, इनवर्स ऑफ द फ्रीक्वेंसी. सो 165 विल टेक हाउ मच टाइम? 6/125 × 360, मल्टीप्लाइड बाई 165. सो दिस इज द आंसर. सो एट दिस टाइम द लाइन जॉइनिंग P' एंड Q' विल बिकम हॉरिजॉन्टल फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम.